afternoon, guys. I've been out doing a few videos, so you'll see a few today. I think I've done about three today. I done a cooking video and I showed off one of my pots. So while I'm already here, I thought I would show how to clean cast iron. I've seen people doing it, right? I've watched a few videos and people do it correctly. Like Cowboy, I can't remember his name, the American guy, Cowboy something. Cast iron, he's like the most famous cast iron person on YouTube, I would say. So I got the tip from him. I think it was Cowboy Ken or something, or Cowboy, sorry, I can't remember his name. So I'll give you a look. So the cast iron's still kind of hot. What his tip was, never put cold water on cast iron because it'll crack. So I'll take you to the fire and I'll show you. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stick the pan back on, heat the pan up again. I've got some water bubbling away. In my billy can. So, very easy. I've seen people doing this video and using kitchen things like scrubbing brushes and things like that. I don't normally take these kind of things with me, so this is what I do, right? Cast iron, frying pan, or skillet, whatever you want to call it. So I just put some water in, hot water, like that. Right, very easy, just like that. Just like that. So, and then I just clean it in the water. I've actually seen somebody doing it with a metal spatula, or whatever you call them, fish thing, I can't remember what you call them. But yeah, I do it with a plastic one. You don't want to scrape your cast iron pan, do you? So there you go, I just give it a waft round about. Sorry, the rain's starting, guys, so I'm leaving anyway. So this is just my last little video that I'm doing today. So there we go, round about. So the spatula's cleaned as well. There we go. And then I'll just swirl it round a bit. Don't try not to tip the water in the fire, because it'll put your fire out. Right, so I'll tip it at the side. So there we go. Most of it is cleaned off, right? What I'll do now is I'll get some moss and things like that, right, over here. So there we go, some of this, right, put that around about the pan. I know you're thinking, oh, he's making it dirtier, but no, I'm not. Right, there we go. Right, back on the water, back on the fire, put some more water in it. We'll leave that till it heats up, right? Then I'll bring you back and I'll show you what to do next. So there we go, guys, the water is heated up. Right, and the pan should be practically clean by now. So I'll tip this water out now. So there we go, the pan. The pan is clean, so you never want to leave your pan like that and put it in your bag. Stick it back on the fire, let it dry out. Stainless steel's porous, so it absorbs that water. Absorbs, sorry, not whatever I said, absorbs. So let this pan dry, and I'll bring you back for last stage, and then we pack it. Right, so the pan is completely dry now. A little bit of a cooking fat, a lard, whatever you call it, beef fat. Spoon was a little bit dirty there, so yeah, add the lard to the pan. Not a lot, just a little bit. So there we go, and I'll wait till that melts down. It seems to work for me. My pan's never rusted. I've had it for a couple of years. I do use it. I've been using it in the house probably more than out in the woods. That's why I thought I would start bringing it out back into the woods. So there we go. Hope that helps somebody. So thanks for watching. Thank you.